let's cover the lawyer audio recording. Many of you should be familiar with it by now. However, if you aren't, click on the card now to see a good overview of it all, presented by Sargon of Akkad. If you prefer someone else, there are plenty of other personalities that have dissected the information gained from the recording. Now, you might be wondering why I don't just cover it myself. The main reason for this being the same as the net neutrality video. The market has been incredibly diluted, and it's extremely simple for you to find someone else who's already covered the subject in great length. You may have further curiosities as to why I even do anything on the subject. The reason for this is because there is one singular part of the video that I want to cover. One that others quickly skim over or ignore from what I've seen thus far. I'm going to play the clip of the audio I'm concerned with most now.
These are very young students, and something of that nature is not appropriate to that age of student because they don't
18?
Have... 18?
Yes. They're adults.
Yes, but they're very young adults.
This is asinine. There is no such thing as a quote-unquote young adult. You are either an adult or you are not. There is an abstract meaning for young adult in psychology, however the definitions vary greatly. The age range for young adult generally falls within 19 to 39. With that in mind, does Laura expect us to wait until students are 39 to start expressing dissenting opinions? It's fucking ridiculous. This mindset is absolutely regressive.
They don't have the critical toolkit to be able to take it apart yet. This is one of the things that we're teaching them, and so this is why it becomes something that has to be done with a bit more care.
So why is this clip so important to good old Max Headroom? Why is it important to you? Why is this problematic? Analyze what they are saying, even how she responds, how this conversation goes from something offensive to they're too young, even when they're considered full-grown adults by society's standards. Well, when will they be considered old enough to discuss these things? If not 18, then maybe 20? 21? 30? 39, as psychology suggests? Where is the line this man draws? Is there one? Or will they forever be too young as long as they don't stand and scream at the teacher's assistant who tries to promote the challenge of ideas? They say your brain doesn't fully develop until you're 25, but does that mean you shouldn't try and challenge your opinions? That you should just be a sheep to whatever exposition is spouted at you that day? Why are we allowed to drive and do tobacco and join the military at 18 but not have our ideas challenged? Why are we allowed to leave the safety net of mandatory schooling if we aren't prepared enough at that time to go and get a job, rent an apartment, watch adult content? This is how it starts. It starts with a, they aren't old enough. Then it continues to be, we just simply can't talk about that, until it becomes, that's illegal to discuss. This is what indoctrination looks like. Well, sounds like. This is what they want to do. They want you to spout the ideologue they desire. Anything outside of that is wrong. Why? Because you might actually be able to change their minds, especially when in a stimulating environment that promotes free thought and ideas. They do not want you to have free thought. They do not want you to be free. They do not want you to be skeptical or ask questions. Listen and follow. That is what they desire. They need to convince these children that what they believe is correct. Even mentioning or discussing anything opposing of that is a bannable offense. This is how colleges and universities view you. Campus is not a place of intellectual debate or stimulation. It's a fucking liberal-making machine. They will put you in, take your money, and push their ideals, regardless of if you want to learn or discuss other options. Think that you're going to be pushed to challenge your ideas and belief? No. They will either laminate what you already believe, pushing the narrative, or they will force you to agree to the extent which they deem acceptable and silence you in any way possible. This teacher's assistant was doing what her job was. She was challenging her students, forcing them into debate and into new ways of thinking they might not have previously considered. And what fucking happens to her? She gets reprimanded, to the extent of needing her teaching plans reviewed, just in case anything she wants to discuss in class is problematic. Remember, you are a child. You need to go to college as long as possible so your thoughts can't be challenged, so you are molded into the SJW the system wants you to be. College is no longer a place of learning or challenging thought processes. It's a place to become a robot with dyed hair, neck tattoos, and genital piercings that can, verbatim, rattle off the narrative your professors told you is true, regardless of its validity. Cause hey, that one study, one time, no matter how disavowed or disproven it was, is true. And fuck you for saying otherwise.
Well, if that hasn't got Oscar written all over it, I'll eat my invitation to the award ceremony.